everybody, and welcome to a new episode of
Jesse's Tips and Tricks.
Do you remember that episode where I said, can we do more advanced things with pictures?
Absolutely.
Do we have time for that in this episode? No. Guess what? There is time for that. And that time is now. So we've talked about the basic 3D effect and how it can bring some liveliness to pictures in your edit. Today, we're taking it to the next level. We are going to separate the foreground from the background and simulate some real 3D movement in our 2D picture, aka the parallax effect. Let's take this picture. Don't ask me why. This is just a picture we're going to be working with, okay? No, I don't want to talk about it. No. Let's just open the picture in Photoshop, okay? Okay, so this is the person in the foreground, and this is the background. We start by duplicating the layer. We'll rename the top layer foreground and the bottom layer background. First, we'll want to cut out the person in the foreground. Back in the day, you had to grab one of the lasso tools and go like. But that all changed back in early 2018. Since then, we can go to select and choose subject. Great Scott! The future is now, old man. Shut the fuck up, Donnie. You might have to tweak the selection a little, but in general, it gets the job done pretty well. After you're done fine-tuning your selection, select inverse by pressing Command-Shift-I or Control-Shift-I. Now hit Backspace. We now have our foreground subject separated on one layer. I know, it's super tempting to press Command-D or Control-D, but control yourself and don't do it.
Why?
Well, because we don't just want to remove the background from our foreground layer, we also want to remove the foreground from our background layer. Okay, so let's invert the selection again by pressing Command-Shift-I or Control-Shift-I and expand the selection by, say, 4 pixels under Select, Modify, Expand. Now, make sure that the background is your active layer and go to Edit, Fill. Make sure that Contents is set to Content Aware. The box Color Adaptation is checked, and under Blending, the mode is set to Normal, and the opacity is at 100%. Now click OK. Turn off the visibility of your foreground layer, and you will see that we now have an empty background, more or less. You can fine-tune the background using the Smudge tool, the Spot Healing Brush tool, or the Clone Stamp tool. Please note that this doesn't have to be a perfect Houdini trick. Your focus should be on the edges of your selection, because we're doing this to create a bit more room to move the foreground and background separately. If you're satisfied, save the foreground and the background as two separate PNG files.
And no interlacing, obviously.
Disclaimer, I don't know if this is the best way to separate the foreground and the background. This is just the way I usually do it. It's fast and effective, but if you know a better way, go ahead. Anyway, enough Photoshop for today. Time to open up Premiere. Import those PNG files and put them on a timeline, the foreground above the background, obviously. And now it's time to play! What usually works very well is when you zoom in, scaling up the foreground a bit more than the background. Say we scale the background from 100% to 110% and the foreground from 100% to 125%. Of course, starting your movement with an ease out and ending it with an ease in. Out of your mama and into the grave. Do you see what that does to your picture? This is not a static still frame anymore. This is a lively image with a real 3D feel to it. You can also move the pictures sideways, making the foreground go a bit faster than the background. To take things even a little further, we can also nest the picture layers and add a bit of swivel or tilt to it using the basic 3D effect. Be creative! Your timeline is your playground! But don't overdo it! Keep in mind what's realistic in terms of the perception of depth. So, with just a few little steps, you've granted life to an otherwise static still frame.